What's going on, y'all? Low-key conversations. Welcome. Curtis Smith here. How y'all doing? How y'all living? How y'all feeling?
I am Colleen Smith.
Oh, my God. That's...
Yeah. Welcome.
She working on it. Yo. She
no, I got it.
You got it?
Yeah, I'm good.
You sure? You positive?
That's who I am.
It's going to invade my personal space and just...
I am Colleen Smith. Welcome to Low-key Conversations.
That works. Whatever. So long as you know who you are.
Mm-hmm.
Comfortable with
I know who I am.
Comfortable with yourself. That's all that matters. What's going on, y'all? Welcome back. Appreciate y'all checking in. Before we really get into it, go ahead and hit that like button, hit that subscribe button, share, smash everything.
You said smash everything.
Smash everything. Smash the like, smash the subscribe, smash the share. Get it out there. Smash. Smash everything. Hashtag smash everything. You cool with that?
No.
No? Okay, she's not cool with the smash anything. let me get
Can
my bearings,
introduce,
man. Stop.
Introduce our
I'm
guest.
I'm getting there, man. Come on, calm with yourself. Appreciate y'all for coming back. I've been getting a lot of good feedback for low-key conversations, and I'm feeling real good about it.
Yeah, you're giving him a huge head.
Pause. What's wrong with you? You don't want that energy, but you keep bringing it over here. Stop it. Appreciate all the love, the support. You guys keep checking in, and it's growing slowly but surely, and that just lets me know that we're doing something right, so I'm grateful for all of y'all. My guest, our guest this week, we got bugs. Everything is real here. We don't play no games. Our guest this week, he's been here before, and... On a platform that was a little bit more, it was a lot more colorful. It was a lot more energetic.
We don't know that yet.
No, stop. Let me finish talking. See this, yo.
Were you just gonna say don't get married?
That's exactly what I was gonna say. Don't get married. Leave the wife at home. Nah. The energy here, we don't know what it's gonna be, but I have no doubt that it's gonna be entertaining. I have my man Cyrus. 13X, welcome back to Low-key Conversations.
Thank you. That's one of the many aliases. That's my barely watching alias. Cyrus 13X.
Oh, I'm sorry.
Cyrus Alexander today.
Right. Maybe when we go back and edit,
that's all good. It's all good. No, that's good. That's the barely watching alias. But you know, that's still family. So we still, you know, that'll work.
I don't know. You sounding like Ralph Tres. What are you, Michael Jackson featuring the Jacksons?
No,
that's
no,
who you going
to say? Nah.
Cyrus 13X featuring the Live Guys.
No, never that.
Controversy.
Never that, man.
I'm joking. Shouts to Barely Watching. Shouts to Live Guys.
Shouts to those brothers.
Shouts to Cobra Karate. Shouts to
D-Mobile.
D-Mobile, Cross the Global, left and jump shipped and went.
Shout out to that brother.
But what's good, B? How you been?
I've been good, doing a lot of footwork, getting prepared for the upcoming Beats and Barbecue Festival.
Yeah, man.
In 3 weeks. So.
Yeah, let's talk about that.
I'm hungry.
You're hungry?
Don't come on, man. All right. So look, Cyrus got Beats and Barbecue.
Right.
The second annual Beats
second
and Barbecue
annual. Yep.
Happening right here in Worcester, Mass. Down at the Worcester Common.
Yep.
On
Saturday, July 21st.
Yeah, man.
So can you tell us a little bit about what's going on?
So yeah.
I'm taking over today.
I'm back.
So for this year's Beats and Barbecue, which will be our second annual, we're gonna have it's a community vibe. It's gonna be a family friendly event, all ages. It's gonna be from 12 p.m. to 8 p.m. and the headliner is gonna be Styles P, and the co-headliner is gonna be Sky Zoo. So
Styles P.
Yes.
LOX.
Yes. LOX as in. Are they going to be there or Styles P?
No, I know he ain't. I know. Listen, you said Styles P only. You ain't say the locks. You said Styles P, so I'm with that.
No doubt. I'm all the way there for that.
Styles P is probably one of my favorites.
Really?
Yeah, man.
Okay. That's the thing. That's one of the reasons
he
why.
Was
so shocked.
He thought I was going to say Ja Rule was my favorite.
Here's the thing. The reason why I booked Styles P is because his likability factor is on 100.
Yeah.
If you were to put like different attributes on an artist,
yep.
and likability would be one of them. Yeah. His likability is on 100.
Yeah.
You know, a lot of people, if you ask 50 people if they like Styles P, 48 of them are going to say, I love Styles P.
Yeah.
He's one of the most liked artists in hip hop. Yeah. Him, Snoop.
Yep.
Mm-hmm. Jay-Z, you know.
Which is crazy to me when you say Snoop.
Snoop. But, so, you know, everybody loves Snoop, though.
Yeah, everybody mm-hmm. loves Snoop now. You know what he evolved into, though? Because you know how many people hated Snoop at the beginning?
Yeah.
And now he's like the grandfather.
He's a grandfather, uncle, you know what I'm saying?
He's actually the uncle.
The uncle at the cookout.
Unk, yeah.
Yeah.
Uncle Snoop. Snoop.
He's not that old yet.
Word. Nah, chill. You don't know that by looking at him. Anything gray. Anything gray.
Oh, yeah. Absolutely.
He got the gray dreadlocks.
I have gray dreadlocks.
Scary.
You know? But Styles P is a likable figure in hip hop.
Yeah.
And he just dropped an album, so the energy was there.
Yep.
And I figured it was, you know, the time was right. I got something on my oh, okay, that was you. You saw him doing that, right? I thought I had something on my beard or something like that. But the energy was right, the timing was right, and I just pulled the trigger and said, let's get Styles.
Yeah.
And my man Sky Zoo just dropped the album in February, and his energy is still going off the momentum of that album.
Yep.
So I figured I'd pair them together, a younger artist with an older mm-hmm. OG artist, put them together, and they could draw those crowds in.
Yeah.
So.
So now, in regards to the Beats and Barbecue joint, like, I didn't make it last year. I'm sorry. I didn't make it last year.
It's all good.
But I heard feedback ridiculous.
Mm-hmm.
Like, the feedback that I heard from it was because you had it at Institute Park.
Yeah.
Last year. Mm-hmm. This year, you're having it at the Worcester Common.
Yes.
Which is a more
centralized.
Yeah, it's more centralized. It's a more mm-hmm. intimate setting. More people have access to it as opposed to traveling to
right.
the distance of Institute Park.
You could take a bus, go right there.
Exactly. Like, mm-hmm. it'll let you off right there, and it's right in the middle of the city. The middle of the city.
Okay.
And, don't judge me.
Do you want me to take over?
Hush.
Okay.
It's right in the middle of the city. I can't. My producer's killing me right now. So I didn't have access. I wasn't able to make it down there last year, but mm-hmm. I heard really, really good things about it.
Yeah.
So in regards to what's the differentiation between what's going on this year as opposed to what happened last year?
Okay, well, this year is going to be more artists.
Okay.
More local acts.
Yep.
It's going to be longer. Last year it was 12 to 6. This year is 12 to 8.
Mm-hmm. All right.
Again, the location. Mm-hmm. That's a big factor.
Huge.
And I have more food vendors.
Yeah.
More merch vendors. A lot more community-based vendors will be out.
Okay.
And a lot more activities for children this
year. All
right.
That's
so. As a matter of fact, from 12 p.m. to 4 p.m., there's going to be an area dedicated specifically for children, face painting, cotton candy. A lot of kid centric things.
Yeah.
Okay. And how do you get tickets for something like this?
Oh, so the Beats and Barbecue, you can go on the website beatsandbarbecue.com.
Mm-hmm.
You just hit the get tickets button and it's right there. Tickets were as low as $5 up to $60 because there's different tiers. But $10 to get you in there, the premium viewing area.
Okay.
Right now. On the day of is going to be 15.
All right.
20 will get you in the premium viewing area plus one meal.
Yeah.
And then when we get to the 40 tier and the 60 tier, that gets you in the after party. And the 60 tier will get you on the stage on the side. So it's different. You know, there's 40 and the 60 tier, like the VIP tiers. Okay. And you get merch and stuff with that.
So we're trying to get on the side.
But you guys are gonna be
yeah, we're gonna be there now.
Media. So y'all, I got you.
We're deemed media now. That's what's up. Like, hey, we got microphones, we're media now. I'll take that title.
I'll be media.
Credentials. We're there to support you, so
absolutely all day.
It'll be fun. And let's talk about the food.
It's the food, okay.
Yeah.
We're gonna have a different okay.
I'm saying, so you can't have beats and barbecue. Like, we know what the beats are, Styles P, anybody coming through.
Yeah.
What's the barbecue?
Well,
who's bringing food?
We're gonna have a few great vendors there. I'll say there's gonna be a great number of food vendors, food trucks from around the city. I'm not gonna name them yet.
All right, it's a secret.
But trust me, it's gonna be, you guys are gonna be in for a treat. It's gonna be a delight.
All right.
it's gonna be something for everybody, you know.
Yeah.
Versatile. Everybody's gonna be happy.
I don't eat pork.
Oh, you're good. You're good. We
barbecue
definitely
chicken.
Barbecue chicken. Barbecue, oh, there's gonna be that in abundance.
I'll eat pork.
There's gonna be barbecue chicken in abundance, you know.
Barbecue pork ribs.
There's gonna be a lot of good stuff there.
All right. What made you? Because I know you, like, for a long period of time, like way, way back, like music was like the staple for you, just like as it was and still is for me. And then you see, I've branched and created this platform, and now you know you've spearheaded the whole Barely Watching movement. You're obviously spearheading the Beats and Barbecue, which is just a small portion of what it is that you're doing. But what was it? What was your motivation to actually initiate the Beats and Barbecue?
Well,
even not even just the Beats and Barbecue, but what was your, what was it in your mind that clicked and said, okay, I'm more than this, like more than the music, and then you know the whole Barely Watching the movies and everything it is that you're spearheading there, and then the Beats and Barbecue, like. What was it in you that made you branch from what you were doing?
Well, that's the thing. That's a gift and a curse for me.
Okay.
Because sometimes I spread myself so thin because I'm doing a bunch of things. I've been like that since I've been in high school.
Yeah.
I've been doing multiple things, you know, film, music, you know, videos, all that type of, writing scripts. I've been doing this since way back.
Yeah.
And so as I've gotten older and garnered more resources to be able to do these things, I've actually put those things into fruition.
Yeah.
It's now shining because, well, now we got technology that everything is, you know, you can distribute things and information easily now. But I've always been like that. I've always had multiple things going on at once.
If you can think it, you can do it.
Exactly. But my problem is sometimes I need to calm my ass down.
Yeah.
You know?
You know what? And that's funny that you say that because... Now, don't tap me because I wasn't even talking about myself.
Oh, just kidding.
Last week, I had Star Delgado on our show, and she hinted towards the same, you know,
slowing down,
like she's doing too much. And you can tap me. Like, yeah, I've felt like, you know, I have my hand in way too many pots all at once. That's just me. That's in my nature. Like, I don't know how to just stay stagnant and focus on one thing. I feel like there's so much that's out there that I can be involved in. And sometimes, yeah, I spread myself too thin. I get too tired or whatever. Like, when does it click for you? Like, because me, I won't stop until somebody smacks me and be like, you know, knock it off. Like, slow down. Like, you don't got to do as much as you're doing. Like, for you, like, what was your, like, what's your leash when you're like, all right, chill, slow down.
When you try things a couple of times and it's not really working the way you planned it, you might want to stop, reassess the situation, and go back to the drawing board and then come back later with what you wanted to do.
Yeah.
I told myself I was going to do that after this Beats and Barbecue.
Yeah.
But the energy for this Beats and Barbecue has been really, really good.
Yeah.
I feel good about the turnout this year. I feel really good about the turnout this year. As opposed to last year was a solid turnout, but this year I think it's going to be it's going to supersede that.
Yeah.
But I think that's with anything.
Anything
when you're
you
just
first
starting
exactly.
out, you got to give it a few times before
absolutely.
You even think about giving up.
Exactly. Exactly. So, yeah, that's my leash, you know, just feeling it out a few times.
I'm really anxious to see because I've seen it. I've seen it everywhere. I've seen the Beats and Barbecue
the promo
advertisement.
Thank you.
The promotion is ridiculous. Like
thank you.
Everywhere I look, like I'm seeing the afro with the shorts.
Like,
I'm seeing it. It's everywhere. So I'm anxious.
Branding. And I'm glad you brought that up. I've always been big on branding.
Yeah.
And the look of things. I take artwork and branding very seriously.
Yeah.
So I'm glad you mentioned that
because
that image is catchy.
Yeah.
The sister with the afro
and
with
it's
the
so
yeah.
subtle.
Blue.
You know
yeah.
what I'm saying? It's
yeah.
so
yeah.
subtle. Nice. It's not. It's nothing that's like overly saturated. You know, like you're not trying too hard. It's something
right.
subtle that when you see it, you know what the association of it is. You know what
right.
I'm saying? Like it's and that I feel like is the key to branding. To you have to be able to see something one time and recognize where it's coming from. You know what I'm saying? Like, you got to be able to see it once, recognize, oh, that's Beats and Barbecue.
Subtle, like, but interesting.
Exactly. Like, it's something that's going to catch the eye, and you already associate it with what it is. And the fact that this is the second go-round for you in regards to Beats and Barbecue, and I keep saying that because I'm really annoyed and I'm aggravated that I didn't make
it. It's all good, bro.
Like, I'm not. I'm annoyed that I didn't make it because you have no idea how many people were talking about it after the fact. And I was I was working.
You gotta do what you gotta do.
I couldn't get out of work. You know what I mean? Like, it was on a Saturday, if I remember correctly.
Saturday.
It was a Saturday.
It was a Saturday.
I was at work from 9 to 5, and it ended at like six o'clock. So it was like I got out of work at 5, and then like there was no way I was gonna make it down there.
Right.
You know what I'm saying?
So now,
I was like, yeah, nah, chill. We
it's still 8 o'clock.
Yeah, we definitely did. I still gotta work. But I mean, I still gotta work. So you gotta pay the bills.
We'll balance it.
Got you.
But I'm gonna be there. We're gonna be there. We're gonna bring the whole low-key conversation, the whole production, the whole brand is going to be there, and we're going to make it happen.
Word.
But now I know that you said after this Beats and Barbecue, you were trying to slow down.
Yes.
But you still got stuff going. Like, I know you do. So what else is going on besides the Beats and Barbecue? Because I know you're spreading yourself way thin right now.
Yes. That's
you
why.
You do your own kind of, is it production?
Why don't you let the man answer the question I asked?
Fine. No, she was going to
ask. I'm joking.
I think she was asking a good question.
Nah, go ahead.
That was a good segue. So I have a project coming out right after Beats and Barbecue. I'm going to keep it under wraps until the day after Beats and Barbecue.
He's so secret.
I have a project coming out. I like 4 days after Beats and Barbecue, and I have a project coming out.
Okay.
It's a big project. I'll tell you off camera.
It's not like, you know. No, you can't take that back. You said it's a big project.
Well, it's a big, well, because it's really never been done before.
You don't want to jinx it?
I mean, I'll tell you guys off camera, but I don't want
to. And then I can.
You don't want anyone else to steal it.
Yeah.
Yeah. I get that. Yeah, no, I respect that. Yeah. I respect that.
But I tell you guys, I tell you guys off camera. I give you guys exclusive.
No, that's what's up. I appreciate
and then I got the film I'm working on, Year of the Rat film. That's going into production in August.
Okay.
Well, we're going to finish production in August. And that's where it stops, you know. So from August until April.
Yeah.
It's going to be, my focus is going to be Year of the Rat. I'm shutting everything else down.
Yep.
The film Year of the Rat is going into production, production, post-production. Then in April, I'm doing a film festival in Boston.
Yeah. Somebody else told me about a film festival.
So that's,
yeah. But I'm assuming that it's the same joint that you're talking about.
I don't know if I've told you before.
Nah.
But it's a film, I'm doing a Black International Film Festival.
Okay.
So it's going to be in Boston. Patriots Day weekend in April 2019.
All right.
And so, yeah, that's going to be how I roll out Year of the Rat.
Okay.
That's one of the ways.
So you're going to present Year of the Rat
at the festival. That's going to be the Boston premiere.
Wow.
So.
All right. Are you the only one? Because, so you got a team. I know you do.
For the Beats and Barbecue?
Yeah.
No.
What?
Just you?
Just me.
Oh, time. Wait.
That's the thing. Last year was just me. This year, it's me as far as the legwork. I do have supportive partners and sponsors. I want to give a shout out to my sponsors, Pac-Man Ghost, Quali TV.
Okay.
Above Average Joe's, YEA Youth Entrepreneurs Alliance, Hope Coalition.
Yep.
Barely Watching, of course, they've been giving me more support. I don't know if they're going to be hosting it. They were supposed to be hosting it this year, but these and Kylie might have a schedule conflict, so they might not host it this year, but they've always been more support. Anything they need from me, I got them. You know, we're still brothers, but time, you know, cats got families and stuff like that. Absolutely. So they might not be able to host it this year.
Yeah.
But.
Yo, the fact that you're able to, like, acknowledge and recognize and appreciate that and not hold it against. So,
right.
Like,
people have a life. So,
yeah. Yeah, like, people got lives. Like, it's. In this, because we've, and when I say we, I mean like just us. Like when we were coming up, we thought there was only one way.
Right.
You know what I'm saying? It was all about the music. You know what I'm saying? Like we was behind the microphone in the studio creating ample music.
Right.
And then it, you know what I mean? Like we, as we got older and became fathers and husbands and what have you, and we grew and we recognized that there are other ways to express ourselves and get our talents out there. Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm. But in this industry that is in front of microphones and behind microphones, entertainment, people don't really recognize. Like, when you have a project, it's like, that's it. Like, that's it. That's the end goal. Like, you got to get this done. I don't give a damn what you got going on beforehand or whatever. But the fact that you can step outside of that and step sideways and say, okay, you got a family. You got this. You got that. You got scheduling conflicts. Yeah. Like, and you can respect it and not hold that against somebody. Yeah. It speaks volumes of your character.
Yeah.
So I respect
that. I mean, because the world don't revolve around me, you know?
Yeah.
So, but me, the type of dude I am, my thing, my whole motto is, if I got to do it, if I have to do it all by myself, it's got to get done.
Yeah.
You know? So it's, if it got to get done, it got to get done.
Sound like me.
You know what I'm saying?
Nah, it got to get
done. I mean, you're here and you're cute little boys.
Thank you.
There,
so. Yeah.
Shouts to the little man in the background. You're like,
chilling.
Hey, listen. We had it last week.
Gotta get it done.
So I respect that.
Yeah. I don't want to leave out Scope Urban Apparel.
Yep.
And Beat Club Podcast. They've also been some supporters. They're going to be at the event as well. So I don't want to leave them out. But shout out to them. But as far as the legwork and getting permits and get booking the artist and promoting and spending the money, that's all me.
That was all you.
Wow.
Yeah.
That's a lot of work.
Again, that just speaks volumes to you know, your determination and what it is that you're trying to get done.
Absolutely.
And you know, you got support over here all
Thank
day.
Thank you. I appreciate
all
that.
All day, you got support over here.
Which is why we will be there to
Yeah, man, we're going to be there.
And the one that we know is there.
Thank you.
Oh, yeah.
Thank you.
You're going to have a following, period.
Thank you.
The fact that, you know, like, that's why I wanted you here. Like, again, like you said, like, the Bailey watching, they got you. And that's just a small piece of what you have your hands in or whatever. But, like, I know that you have more going on outside of what we did last year.
Right.
You know what I'm saying?
Yeah. Absolutely.
Like, that was cool, but this, I feel like, is a bigger scale.
Yeah, you're trying to do something for the city.
Absolutely,
and this is something
which
repetitive.
Which is important.
Yeah.
And that's all I want. Like, just, you know, like, when I had my guest here last week, like, Stars, she's a staple in the city.
Mm-hmm.
I feel like what you're doing also is a serious contribution to what we came from and where we're at now and where we're trying to go. You know what I'm saying?
Absolutely.
It could
be
big. It could be really big, you know?
Thank you.
10 years from now, we'd be like, 10th anniversary of Beats and Barbecue.
Yeah, absolutely. You know? I would love that.
That should be the goal.
I really, this year is like the test.
Yeah.
Because, I mean, first and foremost, the energy has been great.
Yep.
So I want to keep the energy great. I want to thank everybody in the city that has been supportive of this.
Yeah.
But I want everybody to put that into action.
Yeah.
You know what I'm saying?
Like, don't just
people show
don't
up.
Don't talk about
it.
Yeah,
people
it.
Just show up.
Yeah.
Because I will say this, as much as I love my city and I love my peers in the city, your boy gets a lot of love in Boston.
Yeah.
So don't make me look at parks in Boston now.
Move this shit quick.
Come on, man.
I'm just keeping it real. I'm keeping it real.
Son, but look, man, like, come on. All right, ready?
Yeah.
Everybody wants to keep, and I'm going to say this on camera. I don't really give a damn who feel what kind of way about it. Everybody always wants to keep, all right, so Worcester, Massachusetts is the city that we're talking about.
Mm-hmm.
All right? There is a lot that comes out of this city, period.
Mm-hmm.
I don't have to name names. There's a lot that comes out of this city, and the media or whomever else just wants to automatically, when you hear Massachusetts, everybody defers to Boston.
Boston, yeah. Mm-hmm.
Everybody always defers to Boston. But some of the greatest things that have come out of Massachusetts have come from this city.
Absolutely.
Let's be clear.
I agree.
Be clear. Low-key Conversations is coming from a place of Worcester, Massachusetts.
Mm-hmm.
Like, that's period. That's it. It's a Worcester, Massachusetts-based entity. Beats and Barbecue, same thing.
Absolutely, absolutely.
You know what I'm saying? So Worcester, Massachusetts needs to come out and support its city's entities and what its city has contributed.
Mm-hmm.
You know what I'm saying? Like, Boston is great. Don't get it twisted.
Mm-hmm.
I got more love for Boston than people will understand. But we don't live there. We from here. All of the ideas, everything it is that we're presenting to you guys have come from the environment of Worcester, Massachusetts. So recognize and respect and show support to your city and what your city is doing for you. That's all we ask. You know what I'm saying? Like, mm-hmm. this platform was created to bring people together. People from Worcester, Massachusetts need to come together. That's absolutely. It. That's all mm-hmm. I'm saying.
Absolutely.
So come out to Beats Barbecue.
That's right.
God damn it. Yep. Eat some food and support your people.
That's right.
That's it.
That's right. Thank you. That was deep. That touched me.
I don't think it was that deep. No, that didn't. But that's real, man.
Yeah, like, absolutely.
Everybody automatically wants to associate, you know, the greatness of Massachusetts with Boston. That's not always what it is. Like,
right.
There's a lot
right.
of...
Separate the two.
Yeah, like, there's a lot of other places, man. There's other places in Massachusetts that are doing great things that don't have anything to do with Boston. This has nothing to do with Boston. So don't sell yourself short. I'm not saying that you are... But don't sell yourself short.
No doubt.
Trust your city. Your city gonna come out for you.
I believe it. I see we putting that energy in the air.
Yeah,
I like
man.
That.
Your
I like
city
that.
Gonna
They're
come
gonna
out
come
you.
Out. They're gonna come
your
out.
Your city gonna come out for
I
you.
I feel
and
it
not
too.
Even just your city, like other
people,
places
yeah.
are gonna come out for you.
Absolutely.
They will.
Town.
I feel
They'll
it.
Be there.
I feel it.
We got you.
I like the energy.
We're gonna
positive.
Be there.
That's right.
In regards to what's and I know Beats and Barbecue is like your focus right now, mm-hmm. but I gotta ask because the brand itself of Barely Watching is at like that's where it started. As
right.
far as I'm concerned.
Right.
What I know.
Well, we love Barely.
So what is
watching,
the yeah. Nah, we love the live guys. Shouts yeah. to the boys again.
Those are my brothers, man.
What's the status, man? You can't speak on it?
I'll speak on as much as I know. I'll speak on as much as I know.
Because
we
you're
miss
basically the
we miss
creator,
the boys.
Right?
I'm just saying, we miss the boys.
The idea for Barely Watching, yeah. Because we would just bug out in D's living room. I said, this needs to be a project. We need to do this. So it came from that. But as far as the status now, I don't know, man. I don't know. It's hard. Well, let me tell you what happened. So we were here last December.
Yep. Mm-hmm.
We finished the whole season, I think four. I think it was season three of season four. See, season three.
Okay.
We finished the whole season three. January 18th, 2018, my hard drive crashed.
Yeah.
Oh. Season three was on that. So
it's a moment of silence.
Yeah.
For the hard drive.
And I take responsibility for that because I should have backed it up.
Okay.
Along with season three of Barely Watching, I lost a year's worth of beats, some shot lists, some screenplays, some edits.
Mm-hmm.
But luckily the footage that I shot for Year of the Rat was in Google Cloud.
Okay.
In the drive. So that was good. The thing about Barely Watching is we could redo that stuff.
Yeah.
I mean, it was a good season. Season three was good. It was about 6-7 episodes. It was really good.
Yeah.
But we can do that again.
Yeah.
We can redo that. But it's all about timing.
Mm-hmm.
Gotcha.
Like I said, you know, D's, you know, he's got
yeah,
a whole
he's
new
PA.
He's yeah, yeah, he's got a whole new
life.
Thing going, whole new life going.
Yeah.
And you know, Cobra, he has his thing going with his fam.
Yep.
But, you know, if we get time to sit and just do a season, like, we can get, like, if we can get a week in,
yeah,
we can really make some moves,
yeah.
you know. So I think it's possible. I just don't know when.
Nah, I get that. Mm-hmm. I would just say don't give up on that.
Right. Nah, it was beautiful. That's a beautiful thing.
Yeah. That's a great thing.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Like just even thinking about it.
Yeah.
Like, yo, the whole Barely Watching, the whole live guys, like everything y'all did, like that brought a smile to my face.
And that's what we did on Friday night.
Yeah. That was our life. Yo, we would be right down here and we would watch. You know what I'm saying? And I know like when you guys were here last time, D made a little dig or whatever, like, oh, you stole our whole like it's not your, yo. What you guys were doing, what you orchestrated and what they facilitated and put out there was a really large motivation for this whole low-key conversation.
You guys,
it really was. Because it
really,
was like...
You guys did it better.
That.
No, but you guys...
See, don't do that. Don't say we did it better. Because that's
you
not...
did. We didn't have no damn lights.
That wasn't the goal. You know what I'm saying?
I mean,
like,
that's
I reached
our production
out,
team making us
yeah, like, that's not me.
Hot.
Like, this is... this. It's not just me. It's not just her. It's like the whole low-key conversation, mandated entertainment, like the whole brand, the whole When All Else Fails, the podcast, everything is... It's just we're not staying stagnant. Like we're following suit.
Mm-hmm.
Mm-hmm.
You know what I'm saying? Like you laid a platform. You know what I'm saying? When you did the Barely Watching and then you did like the live at 9 and now you're doing the Beats of Barbecue and the movies and all of that. Like you showed that you don't have to just have tunnel vision.
Right.
You know what I'm saying? Like it's a broad spectrum.
Right.
You know what I'm saying? And you guys were a huge motivation. Like I had this idea in my head for a long time, but you guys were the push and the motivation for me to be like, okay, like this is like, you know what I'm saying? Like you guys were the motivation and the push to be like, okay, yeah, like there's more to it. No and doubt. You can actually facilitate and do it. And y'all did it from the couch in the living room.
Yeah.
Like, we doing it from the basement.
It's like the Black Wings girls.
Yes, I'm like.
Yeah.
So can I ask, you said something about you lost the hard drive, it crashed. Beats on it.
Yeah, man.
So do you make beats too?
Yeah, I'm a producer. Well, that's what a lot of people know me for. I'm a producer.
I didn't know you for
music that. Producer. I've been known for that for like about the past 20 years, just making beats.
Nigga ain't never gave me no beats.
Okay. Well, we can change that. We can work.
He never gave me no beats.
I thought you retired.
I ain't retired. I ain't had no production.
Oh, okay. Well, then, I had no production. Well, let's talk. For sure.
He had no beats.
I had no beats.
Okay. Well, then.
Had no beats,
B. We could talk about. Okay. Well, now we got another discussion to have. You know what I'm saying?
That'll be season 3.
You know what I'm saying?
Season 3.
Yeah. I had a lot. And that was some of my best work that I lost. Yeah. In that hard drive crash. It was a lot of great
you
work.
You get it back.
I'll get it back. Exactly.
You get it back. No, you ain't gonna never get that back. Don't get it twisted. Like right. It's gone. Let's go.
But
you'll I'm saying if the creativity was there, wanted to come back.
Absolutely.
You know what I'm saying? Like you know what it was that you created.
Mm-hmm.
You'll get it back.
Absolutely.
It's not really a huge loss.
Mm-hmm.
It sucks.
It does.
But if you lost it, then it wasn't meant for you to have it. You gotta create something better.
Absolutely.
And I believe
beats
that.
And barbecue.
Yeah. There you go.
And we did.
There you go.
We definitely did.
Thank you.
So what else? All right, so you got Beats and Barbecue coming up. Give them the date again.
Saturday, July 21st, 12 p.m. to 8 p.m. All ages. Children 12 and under get in for free. Bring the whole family. It's a family-friendly event. It's going to be positivity, community-driven event.
Yeah. I'm there. Mm-hmm. Yes. I'm not missing this one.
We'll be there.
We're going to be there.
Yes.
We're definitely going to be there. No, you don't got to thank us, man. It's all love.
Appreciate
it's
it,
It's all
man.
Love. I want to I got one more question for
yeah.
you. I got one more question. So Styles P.
Yes.
Oh, I thought you were gonna bring up the other initial.
What?
I don't know what we were talking about.
Go ahead. What you talking about?
Cardi B.
Nah man, I'm not asking about Cardi. She want me to ask you so hard. Alright, I'm gonna ask you, what you think about Cardi B?
I think Cardi B.
Wait.
What?
Because I see where your energy is at.
You just don't want her to be trash.
Hold up. Come on. Say, come on. All right, go ahead.
I think Cardi B is interesting. I think she found her lane, and she's doing her thing in her lane, and she's a success story. She came from nothing, and good for her. You know what I'm saying?
All positive vibes over here, Five. Thank you very much. Appreciate you.
Anyways.
I think that her album was well done.
Mm-hmm.
And I'm gonna leave it at that.
Right.
I think it was a very well put together project, period. And I'm leaving it at that.
Good.
I've never heard the album.
Okay. And even with you never hearing the album, that's still your energy towards her situation.
Mm-hmm.
Thank you very much, Cyrus. I appreciate you.
No doubt.
It's
so,
hot.
Yeah, it's hot. All right. So, anybody remember? Go check out Beats and Barbecue.
You had a question about Styles P, though.
No, I didn't, though.
You did?
I didn't have a question. I was going to ask about Styles, but at the end of the day, everybody knows who Styles is.
Oh, okay.
You know what I'm saying? Like, everybody knows who Styles P is. My question would have been really, what's the word I'm looking for?
I thought you was going to...
Newt?
I thought you was going to ask, how's it a family event if you got Styles P? I thought you was going to hit me one of those.
Styles got... Come on, man.
Because I've been getting... I got that question a couple times. How are you going to have kids there when you got Styles P?
But he's performing it later on.
I get by.
He's performing at like late, yeah.
So the kids can have all their fun during the
early,
day.
Exactly.
Everybody get by.
Right.
Everybody get by.
You doing the edited version?
Everybody get by. How's that not positive? Everybody get by.
Right.
We get by.
Right, exactly.
Every day, everybody gets by.
I don't think he's going to do that version, though.
No, but we get by. Come on, man. Everybody get by. Out of all of them? Out of all of the locks, out of Jada, out of Sheik,
yeah.
For an event like this, I would want Styles.
Probably stop. Exactly.
You know what I'm saying? Just because of his backstory, I would think Styles is the perfect artist to be there. Facts. Yep.
Thank you.
So you did good.
Thank you.
You did good.
So
you did good.
July
21st. July 21st.
Why are you trying to make people late for the party? Trying to make people late for the party. July 21st.
July 21st.
Saturday, July 21st.
12 to 8.
And we can put the link on how to get tickets?
Yeah. Beatsandbarbecue.com. Or Well, yeah, you can go on the Facebook page. There's a ticket link right there, or beatsandbarbecue.com.
Yeah.
You
know? Now we definitely
$15 at the door.
We're $15 at the door.
Share, yep. We'll share the link on both, you know, low key Facebook page, the Instagram, Twitter, everything. We got you.
Sam. Awesome. Thank you.
All right. I want to thank Cyrus.
Thank
Alexander. You. Cyrus Alexander. Yeah, we can do that. Yeah, so I'm getting my
executive. Way too
on.
Many names.
Get my Russell Simmons on.
What name is cutting the checks? What's cutting
Cyrus
the checks?
Alexander.
Cyrus Alexander.
That's the one.
We're going to thank Cyrus Alexander for coming through. We're going to see y'all next week. We appreciate y'all for coming through. Make sure y'all go down July 21st, Worcester Common, between the hours of
12 p.m.
and
8 p.m.
And check out the event, man. Yes. Styles P coming through, blessing us. Beats and barbecue. Food is going to be involved.
That's
if
right.
Y'all don't come for nothing else. Come for the food.
Come for the food. That's right.
All right. Curtis Smith here signing off. Colleen.
Smith.
That's your name? Sure? I'm just saying, B. Identity crisis every week. I'm just trying to make, be clear. Who
just
are you this
stop.
Week?
Stop.
Colleen Smith? Curtis Smith?
I'm about to be the
Cyrus
host
Alexander.
Of this show.
You wish. And we out. Appreciate y'all coming through. See y'all next week. One.